Here's how you fly a helicopter. Before you sit in the pilot's seat, we want to show you how helicopters work and how they fly. We'll start with the main rotor. We can divide modern rotor systems into the following categories: articulated rotor systems, hingeless rotor systems, and bearingless or semi-rigid rotor systems. Before we can move on to aerodynamics, we need to be aware of the most important aerodynamic principles. Lift is the most important principle. For an aircraft to be able to lift off the ground, a force equal to or greater than the weight of the aircraft has to be applied upwards. The lift is generated by the blade profile on the wings. If the wing moves forward, the profile splits the airflow that now runs at different speeds above and below the wing, and this creates lift. This is accomplished through forward speed in fixed-wing aircraft and through the rotational speed of the rotor in helicopters. The upper curvature of the profile causes a higher airflow rate, thereby leading to a reduction in pressure. Suction or negative pressure is generated on the surface of the blade. For an aircraft to actually fly, the blade and the airflow must be slightly inclined, which deflects the air downwards. There is now positive pressure on the underside of the blade, and this increases total lift. The negative pressure on the upper blade surface also increases, as the air has to travel further through greater curvature, and is thereby accelerated more intensively. The larger angle of attack also increases air drag, which must be compensated for by more operating power. In a helicopter, the greater the angle of attack of the rotor blades, the more operating power that is required. In an aircraft, propulsion is provided by either a propeller or a jet engine. In the case of a helicopter, the rotor is powered by piston engines or turbines. The rotor blades constantly spinning at the same speed create lift and accelerate the air from above to below. This happens because the angle of incident and angle of attack of all of the rotor blades increases simultaneously. The constant rotation allows helicopters to fly forwards, sideways, and backwards, or hover in the air. When hovering, the aerodynamic forces are distributed symmetrically over the rotational radius. To this end, lift must be exactly equivalent to the weight of the helicopter. Increasing the angle of attack increases lift, and the helicopter begins to climb, while decreasing the angle of attack causes the helicopter to descend. To prevent the fuselage of the helicopter from moving against the rotational direction of the rotor, most models feature a vertically rotating tail rotor that compensates for this torque. To fly forwards, the rotor plane is tilted forward, so that the airflow is slightly accelerated backwards. The rotor plane is thereby inclined in the direction in which the helicopter is supposed to fly. What is known as gliding flight for a fixed-wing aircraft is called auto-rotation for a helicopter. If the drive fails during flight, the pilot reduces the collective pitch angle. The result is a wind turbine effect, and the rotor speed is maintained. This allows the pilot to make a controlled descent and land the helicopter. Three different flight controls are used to control helicopters. The joystick, also known as the cyclic control, is operated with the right hand and serves to move the helicopter to the left, right, forwards, or backwards. Pilots must not let go of the cyclic control at any time during flight. Pilots use the foot pedals to control the tail rotor, which allows the helicopter to rotate around its vertical axis. The collective control is operated with the left hand, and pilots use it to influence the climb and descent of the helicopter. The combination of all three flight controls is the only way to achieve and maintain controlled helicopter flight. This means that as soon as the pilot alters one of the three flight controls, the other two controls must also be altered. Now you know the most important technical basics of helicopter flight. Are you ready for liftoff? A test flight will allow you to discover the fascination of helicopter flight. Our pilots are happy to advise you.